Good day guys, and welcome back to yet another video. In today's video, we're gonna talk about the brand new update for LumaFusion. This is gonna be the LumaFusion 3.1 update. We're gonna talk about the features which we will get in this update, if it's free or if it's paid, and we're also gonna take a look at some examples of how this update works. I cannot show you something from the UI because it's the beta version and I have full respect for the team over at LumaTouch, so I won't be showing you any of that, but I'm gonna show you some examples of exactly how it works and what you can expect. This update is gonna be amazing if you like color grading. And we're also going to talk about some of the next features which will be coming a little bit later, some of the features that I have been able to test out as well, and from what I'm seeing it shouldn't be that long. So without further ado, let's get over to the sample footage here and let's take a look at the features which will come in LumaFusion's update 3.1. So about a year ago or so, It's actually been quite long, we were announced that speed ramping, scopes, multicam editing, and easy ease keyframes would be coming to LumaFusion at a point, and that these features were in development. Me, amongst many others, have been testing most of these features already, and we've been reporting bugs after bugs. But now it's actually getting closer to a release. So let's talk about some of the features that will come in this 3.1 update and which features we will see in the next update. So when this was first announced, all of the features would be an in-app purchase. But now with the 3.1 update, everyone will get scopes. Scopes will be completely free for everyone that owns a copy of LumaFusion. Now, how does the scopes actually work and how can you benefit from using scopes? Well, the video scopes will allow you to do more accurate color grading, or if you want to copy something from, let's say, a Hollywood movie that you like, you can go into the color specter of that. You can look at that inside the scopes and you can try to copy the same effect, like copy the same color grading style and make your own presets out of that. Just an example of what you can do with it. Now, this will also have a skin tone indicator, which helps you maintaining the true skin colors of your subject. And as the video scopes, we will get histogram, waveforms, and vector scope. Now, the vector scope is what we're gonna use when we are color grading a subject, a person, and we want the optimal skin tone. The vector scope has a skin tone line or a skin tone indicator, which is indicating the direction you need to push your color to have a more natural skin tone. We're gonna come back to this later once the update is live. And for the video scopes itself, you should be able to choose between how many video scopes that you want to have on your timeline or inside the color and effect section. So you can choose whether to have three next to each other, or you can have two. You can have one bigger and one smaller, the one way or the other way, and you can also stack them on top of each other or choose to have a single one. And what I think you will be using the most is the video scope waveform. This is what you will use to prevent clipping in your highlights and shadows. Now, as for different settings that we will see in the scope section, is that you can turn off the different color channels. So you can turn on and off the red, green, blue, and Luma channels, depending on your preferences and what you are looking for when you are color grading your image. And as for scaling the scopes, you can also make them bigger or smaller depending on your personal preferences. It's just like we can on the timeline section, where we have the source and our clips, the preview and our timeline. Now, like I said, this update is going to be completely free if you own a copy of LumaFusion. And you can actually expect the update to be available in App Store at the end of this month. Now, give or take a week or two. For the remaining features, which will be added alongside with the scopes, is the option to add multiple layers of color presets or LUTs. Now, like I said in the beginning of the video, I won't be able to show you the layout of this, but I will show you some examples of how it works. Now, having the option to add multiple color presets or LUTs means that you can now apply a correction LUT, then do your color correction, and then your final color grading on top of that. Or you can add multiple layers of the color presets, where the first one is the correction, The second one is the color adjustment or grading, and the last one is the additional color tweak. And of course, if you want to spice it up even more, you can add a fourth or a fifth or how many color presets you want. Now, I'm not sure if there is a limit yet or if it will be a limit on the release, but I found that adding three layers is actually more than enough, and then you can add a LUT on top of that as well. Now, another key feature which is coming is multiple audio effects. This way you can add multiple audio effects just like the color presets. So if you can't push the audio effects longer than you want, you can add another one of the same effect and push it in the direction you want. Or you can just stack as many low pass filters as you want. You don't want to, you know, stack too many, especially when it comes to the color presets. Stacking too many layers, you will destroy the color and destroy your video. But we're going to come back to how you can best use this once we have the live version in the App Store. Now, if you haven't already, and if this is the first time that you are checking out one of my videos, thank you for joining in, and make sure to hit that subscribe button, notification bell, and follow me on Instagram for more awesome videos and behind the scenes. Now, in addition to these two updates, there will also be an update to the user interface and layout of the app, which makes it more clean. So these are the updates which will be coming at the end of this month, but keep in mind that it might be a few days before or after. It all depends on the bugs being reported and how long it takes to fix them. And last, the features which I expect to be coming very soon after the release of 3.1. And this is going to be the ECE's keyframes and also the multicam editing. From what I've seen, these two features are getting close to being completed. So I'm not sure how long it's going to take, but I think we can expect them to come sooner than later, hopefully not that long after the next 3.1 update. And these two features, the ECE's keyframes and the multicam editing, will most likely be an in-app purchase. The price of these are yet to be announced, but Terry announced that the price of these features would be fairly small. And it's also going to be a one-time purchase. So once you get it, you have it forever on any of your devices. So these are the brand new features which will be free in the 3.1 update, and the features that we will see pretty soon. Like I said, give or take a week or two from the end of this month, I will be back with an updated video on the scopes and everything once we have it live in the App Store. So I'm really looking forward to the scopes and being able to use multiple color presets to make the moody colors that I always wish I could in LumaFusion. Now we can that, and it's really, really simple. So I will be back with a tutorial as well on all of these features and what's new and what's coming and so on. So that's going to be the end for today. Really hope that you enjoyed this announcement. Make sure to check out the latest video about LumaFusion, and if I quit LumaFusion and if I will continue with LumaFusion, and also the latest Hawaii video, which is epic. It's an amazing sound design there at the beginning, is what I think. So make sure to check out that as well. Let me know down in the comment section as well. I'm not going to keep you here any longer now. Make sure to hit that subscribe button, notification, and let me know in the comment section below which feature are you looking forward to. Which one is your preferred feature? And is there anything else that you would like to see in the future which was not yet announced in this video? So with that said, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.